Please don't watch this video if you don't want to save your time every single day. Yes, that's right. Because I have a VBA code for you that will help you to save at least 1 hour every single morning while working in Excel. You know what? When I used to work for a paper manufacturing company, I used to spend 1 hour every single morning to split data from one workbook to multiple workbooks. Now, the same thing can be done with a single VBA code and in a few seconds. So make sure to watch this video till the end. And now let's get started. All right, so here I have my workbook with the data that I want to split. And now let me show you, I have 50,000 rows in this data and I want to split this data based on the state. In the state column, I have not the complete name of the states, but you know, abbreviations. And I want to have separate workbook for each state. I do this manually by copy-pasting data into a new workbook and then save that workbook in the same folder. It will take me at least 40 minutes to do this. But with the VBA code, I'm going to do this with just a few seconds. So let me go to my developer tab. And then I'm going to go to my Visual Basic. And from here, insert and then module. My code is ready and I'm going to copy this from my notepad and I'm going to paste it here. And now I'm going to close my Visual Basic editor. And now let me show you the folder where I have this main file. So this is the folder where I have the main file. Let me minimize it. And now let me open the macros. And here I have this code. And now the moment I run this, it asks me to specify the column which I want to use for this split. Like, I'm going to use states, so it will create all the workbooks based on this column using the states. So I'll specify G because alphabet is G, the column G, and I'm going to click OK. So it says ready to create 51 workbooks based on the values in the column G. Continue. Yes. And now it will take a few seconds, just a few seconds. Operation is completed. So we have now 51 different workbooks based on the data we had in this workbook. So let me click OK and let me take you to the main folder. And you can see here I have all the workbooks, literally all the workbooks ready. And let me open one to see if the data is all right. So data is there, everything is there, and I have my data ready in different workbooks. All right, so now it's time to understand how this VBA code works. But before that, I want to remind you that always, always, always make a backup of your file if you're actually running a quite lengthy VBA code. Because this VBA code takes care of a lot of things. There might be a chance that you will face an error. So that is why I am requesting you to have a backup. Otherwise, this code takes care of almost everything that you need while splitting your data. So in this code, first of all, we have these variables to save a few values while running the code. And then we have these lines which actually disable all the display alerts and screen updating so that you can focus on other tasks while running this code. Now, moving ahead, we have this line of code which actually specifies that we are using this code in the active workbook. And after that, we have this part of this code which actually specify the sheet that we're going to use while splitting the data. So I'm using the sheet one. If you have any other sheet, let's say the name of the sheet is data or sales data, you can edit that name from here. So this is the one thing that you need to do while using this code for yourself. Otherwise, this code is perfectly fine. You don't need to change anything in the code, just the name of the sheet. If you don't change the name of the sheet, here we have this part of the code that will ask you if the sheet one is not there. It will ask you to specify the sheet number where you have the data and you want to split the data. But I just want to request you always change the sheet name from here so that you always have the correct sheet name at the first place in your code. Now, moving ahead, we have this part of code which actually asks you to specify the column. You have seen that when I ran this code, I had this input box to specify the column number. And this part of the code is actually shows me that particular input box. And after that, we have this small part of code which validates the column letter. And now these three small parts of the code verifies your data starting from A1, and it just captures the entire region of the data. And then it checks if your column that you have specified as a column alphabet has data or not. Now, this part of code checks for the path of the workbook where you have the current workbook. And now this code is going to save your all the new workbooks. And now this entire part of this code creates a loop that copies the data, which actually filters the data first and then copy it, create a new workbook, paste it there, save the workbook, the name that is there, and then close that workbook. And this loop continues until all the workbooks, the entire data is splitted into different workbooks. And after that, we have a simple message, hey, the operation complete and successfully created that number of workbooks for you based on the values we have in the column. Here in the end, we have two more codes that help the main code to work properly. So this code helps to identify if there's any invalid character in the names of the workbook. And this code helps to format the name of the column. And in the end, I want to request you again, make sure to have a backup of your file.